England won. Woo! First time ever in penalty shootout in history.
Yeah, Sam is so happy.
I'm so happy. We should have won in a normal time, but and then extra time was a fucking mistake. Like, we suck. We were horrible.
Yeah.
We're lucky. We made it to penalties in the first place. But, and then we won, which was amazing. And now we're going to make the finals because we're the best.
We watched the match together, and it's really awesome that Russia, the team I'm supporting, because I'm from Uzbekistan, Russia is next to us, really have a big influence on us, to be honest. Post-USSR country. So, yeah. And this guy is supporting England because he was born in England. So, like, the fact that they're on quarterfinals.
Still in the game.
Fantastic.
We still got teams to support.
Fantastic. Well, anyway, we just wanted to switch it up. Like, start a different intro.
We just did an hour long top 10 albums video.
Yeah.
So we're just trying to freshen it up a little.
Yeah, but today, right now, we're gonna talk about top 10 singles, songs.
Not necessarily singles, just.
Yeah, just songs. Yeah. And we can just jump into it.
Yeah, we can.
There we can.
Yeah, I love it.
Maybe you should start first.
Oh, yeah, I'm gonna start.
This time, yeah.
So this time we're gonna change a little because I know Bob hasn't heard some of the songs on my list, and I don't know if I've heard all the ones on his.
Yeah.
So we're gonna play a little bit of each song to kind of give you a taste and also each other of what our thing is. Yeah. So my number 10 is Higher Higher by Justin Timberlake.
Off of
what's it called? Man of the Woods.
Yeah, that's
I mean,
so
if you watch the last video, I really like that album.
Okay.
And that song is probably my favorite off of there.
Mm-hmm.
Just got that soul, it's a soul feeling. It just feels good, and you can just sing to it.
I want to listen to Higher Higher, to be honest, because I don't really remember which exactly that's what song was it for. Oh, that one. Okay. But you're special. I like that. When it goes with the bass. Yeah, I love it. Money is fine. Got you right. Yeah.
But yeah.
Yeah.
So that's my
okay. Okay. I just realized that my list is on in here, so I'll pull it up as well. My number 10 is Kelly Just After the Storm featuring Tyler Creator.
I really like that song too.
Yeah. As I told you, like, I crafted this list, like, when I was doing it, like, I probably changed it, like, 15, 20 times. And, like, it ended up in the final version because it's just, like, first of all, her album, but second of all, when it came out as a single before this album, I just really loved it and I was listening to it a lot. And the way I crafted this list as well because is... It was by the repeat value method, so I had to listen to these songs I put it in more than 1 month or 2 months or even 3 months, or like it should have been like all year round kind of for me. That's why like there will be no songs after April kind of thing. So this song, yeah, it's stuck with me. It's been stuck for like 3 months. Right now, I'm not really listening to it, but I just love the production, the soul. I love the lyrics. I can't remember exactly right now what she was saying there, but like, actually, it was like after the storm meant like, even though there will be bad times, like you should rely on yourself and like you can overcome things. I just really love the message and like. The wordplay was pretty cool too. I really liked it.
You wanna play a little bit?
Yeah. Just so nice. Like, her voice is so soothing. Yeah.
I like that song too.
Yeah.
Okay, my turn.
Mm-hmm.
Number 9, Ray Sremmond, Bedtime Stories featuring The Weeknd.
Okay.
To be
like
completely honest, I never got through the whole album because it's hella long.
Yeah, it's
and true. I would start it and I just would never finish it.
Yeah.
But that song, I mean, it's at the very beginning and it's The Weeknd. Like, I listen to it even if I wasn't listening to the album. It's The Weeknd. You have to listen to The Weeknd features. But it's just such a weird song, mm-hmm. but it's nice. It just sounds nice.
Yes.
It's like, damn, why, where? But it's just like, whoa. Yeah. You know, I can't even describe it with the real words.
I really want to play it because I really enjoy this.
Let me. I have my plans. Like, I'll just play it on
the Yeah.
Just when it drops, when the weekend goes like.
Yeah. His voice.
Yeah.
This is so amazing. I'm not looking at you, I'm looking right through you.
Say I'm not like those other niggas. Ready for the bass?
Yeah.
It's just like, oh.
Yeah, it's just so good. I really love this track too. Didn't end up on my list, but I'm glad it did on yours, definitely.
I feel like we have a very different list, and that's good because you get two times the song.
Yeah, yeah. My number 9 is Logic Overnight.
Okay.
Because I love the message of it. Overnight, he says that you have to work hard on the things. Nothing comes really easily, and like it's a scam. Like the rich,
rich get richer.
Huh?
Rich get richer.
No. Fuck, I forgot that slogan. But anyway, like, nothing comes too quick. Like, you get rich immediately. Like, it doesn't happen like that. And it's like when you see, like, for example, like, let's say people like Daniel Bricoli, like, Catch Me Outside Girl, like, suddenly blowing up. Like, yeah, like, we can, like, see why, like, is she even popular and stuff like that. But, like, they did stuff which other people didn't, and that's why they're there, you know, like it happens for a reason. And I'm really glad that Logic brought it up, and really, it's such a fun track as well. I really love the video as well. Yeah, I just really enjoyed it listening.
Give it a break.
Yeah. Maybe you should just be the intro like this. That's it. Squad, bitch. All these bad bitches say they love me, I already know. Yeah, the video is pretty cool. Yeah, and I just want to mention another thing. The lyrics, I just remembered, like, tell me the reason, like, why you cannot be, why is it so hard to be a good person?
Yeah,
I really love that line as well. And he says, stop acting like a bitch. Like, I really love that line too.
Did act like a bitch?
Yeah. All right.
My number 8 is Neo.
Okay.
LA Nights.
LA Nights. Okay, I will definitely give a listen to that one.
That's also my, it was my number 8. Oh shit, I'm not gonna talk about the albums right now, but it was one of my albums that I enjoy a lot from this year. And that song, out of all of them, I think it was the third track, really stood out to me. It's just like such a cool, like, nice track to just listen to. Just like, chill.
Mm-hmm.
And play a little bit. Oops, no, shit. Spoilers.
Ooh, damn, like, it's pretty good already. The beat.
It's very new.
Damn. Okay, I'm loving it.
There you go.
Yeah.
I love that song so much.
Yeah.
It's such a good song.
Is it number 8 right now?
That was number 8, yeah. So you're number 7. Oh no, I went first. So yeah. Wait. Did I go first? What was your number?
It's your number 8, right?
That was my number 8.
Okay, my number 8 is coming now.
Okay.
The Weeknd called out my name.
Okay.
Yeah. We already talked about it on the albums. Hopefully you watched the video, but if you haven't, I will just say that The Weeknd, we're just a fan of The Weeknd. Just like, it's pretty much a single, like one of the 6 great songs he released out of his album, My Dear Melancholy. Just pick one of them. Yeah, that's my choice.
You gonna play it?
Yeah.
I mean, everyone's heard this song, like, but here you go.
Yeah.
You know this song.
Yeah,
we all know this song. Even if you live like in a, under a rock, you've heard it from someone. Like someone drove by playing it.
Well, we should stop, I think. Yeah, 34 seconds in. Oh. Yeah, amazing song. I love it. It's yours.
My number seven is The Weeknd.
Oh, really?
Wasted Times.
Oh, okay.
Wasted Times, because I feel like Wasted Times is a little... This song kind of got overplayed. I really like this song. But Wasted Times, I'm just going to play it. I mean, there's not really much to say. It's The Weeknd. Like, just like you said.
Yeah. Wasted Times. Great song. Wasted times, I slept with someone else. She wasn't even half of it. Reminiscing how you felt.
And on the drops.
Even though I would not like to have.
Well, it's The Weeknd, so we should pause it because copyright, but
yeah.
Not much to say. Come on.
Yeah.
That's all you got.
Amazing. Track 7, I mean, not track, like,
yes, track 7 on the album.
Not on the album.
Yeah, I'm kidding. On the top 10 album.
Yeah, spot 7. Bass in Mine. I put it because, as I told you, like, it was released in January. Like, it was really at the beginning of the year, became a meme. It's just like, I felt like I should include this song because everybody liked this song, and like
it's
it was a really good song. Pretty influential song of this year. I personally also like it a lot. Like, I had a lot of doubts, like, should I even put it on top 10? But the reason I put it because, as I said, over play value, and I really listen to it a lot with my friends, with my sister. Like, I listen to it a lot. Not necessarily I listen like myself when I was alone with my headphones, but yeah, I just still listen to it a lot with other people.
Yeah. Everyone knows it.
Yeah.
From the Snapchat filter.
Yeah.
No, I just
had a little bit too much of Hennessy.
That's all you need.
That's a really great song, yeah.
That's a really good song, I agree. Okay, my number 6, Kanye West, All Mine.
Yes.
Off of that album.
Yes.
It's just so many crazy sounds, and obviously there's some like that are more lyrical, and I really like those too. But as a song, like that, I would say, hey, listen to this song. This is the song.
Mm.
All Mine is going like that's how I describe it. Yeah, after the organs go by, and it's suddenly like.
Tied up. No feature.
Tied up. I mean, there's Kanye. He's in it.
Yeah, he will be after the chorus.
But obviously, I can't play the whole thing. But the chorus gets you into it. So to listen to the Kanye part.
If I pull up with the Caravage, then that's gonna be enormous scandal. Yeah, it's a really great song. I wanted to mention the Ghost Town song as well. Like, it's not on my list, but I just wanted to mention it because I didn't mention it on the album. It's also another great song on the Ye album. It's just like, I really love the singing of like, and the lyrics behind it, like, and nothing hurts anymore, I feel kinda free. Like, it's just, I love it,
love it.
Alright, what do I have on number 6, right?
Yeah.
You're not gonna like it.
It's Migos, isn't it?
Yeah, BBO, Bad Bitches Only, featuring 21 Savage. I included it because, as I said, I really had fun time with the album, but there's a period from track 2 to track 4 Superstars, Narcos, and BBO songs, like, really had a lot of fun listening to those. And the BBO, I could have been any song out of that trio, but I chose this one because of 21 Savage. I just really like him, just wanted to give him a shout out and like spotlight, like shine on him, because I really like him these days. Well, I don't want to listen to you next to you because you're not going to...
Oh, yeah, but I mean...
It's a clean version. But yeah, it's pretty fun. And I like the ending, just wanted to also show you. Okay. Ah. Yeah, shit. Like, it's just like, I really like to parody Takeoff. His voice is different, like, it's like, I really like to sing along with him. I don't know, it's just fun Jack.
Okay.
Yeah.
I'm not gonna think of it. My next one is this one you've not heard the person or the song.
Mm-hmm.
It's a Canadian song. It's a Joshua Ramsey called We Should Be Friends.
Okay.
It's kind of, I feel like it's very off of like what I usually listen to, and it's kind of weird style, but it just like the vocal gets me, like it sounds so nice to,
mm-hmm.
just like to listen to. I think it's off of some movie. It's like a movie song, but it's just like, and Joshua Ramsey is off of Mariners Trench, which is like one of my favorite Canadian bands.
Mm-hmm.
So I was like, okay, might as well give it a listen, and it sounds really good. It's very like acoustic-y style. But once it gets, I kind of want to skip to the chorus.
Pretty good song. Reminds me of something.
It's a very like,
you know that song? Oh, hold on, just sorry. Just remind me of that. Oh, not you than me.
Yeah.
What is it? Not you than me or something like that.
I know. Wait. Let me think. That's a white. Fuck, what's it called? It's Delilah by Plain White Tees.
Who?
Hey Delilah. Na, 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 na.
Yeah, that song, yeah.
Uh-huh. Kind of similar.
Yeah. Fuck, how do I know that song? anyway. So, and that was your number 5.
That was only number 5, yes.
And what do we have? Oh, I have Cardi B, I like it.
Okay.
Number 5, just a Latin song, pretty great song. Just really love the sample, really love Cardi's performance. Just so like passionate, like it's like fun. Yeah, the lyrics, great song. And also Cardi B, also J Balvin and Bad Bunny's performances weren't bad either. I don't really enjoy them, but they're pretty good too. Good enough to make a great song.
And obviously, it was good enough to be a radio hit. So.
Yeah, and it's, by the way, it became number 1 yesterday on Billboard 100.
Well, there you go.
Yeah,
they like it too.
That's true. Oh, your turn.
You want to play it first?
Oh, yeah. You Yeah, well, anyway, yeah, that's a good,
you know,
song. Yeah.
If you've watched TV or been anywhere in the world. my next song, number 4, is kind of depressing song. It's also RIP again, XXX, The Remedy for a Broken Heart, Why Am I So in Love?
Mm-hmm.
Just like I always like when X does that kind of like droning thing,
mm-hmm.
where he's like, it sounds nice to me. And just the style of that, and this song, he does it so well. And then he has this, it's like a slower beat, but then he spits a little, mm-hmm. and it just sounds like the flow is just so, for me, it just fits perfectly mm-hmm. with the song. So I'm just gonna play it real fast. It's a very short song. I can also play the whole thing, but we're not gonna.
How long is it?
No, it's not that short.
It's not that short.
I lied. I
like this song actually too. It's not this song. I don't know why this wasn't on the charts when she died, and like, there were a lot of songs, but not this song. Mm-hmm. Well, I don't know. Mm-hmm.
The drone, I guess.
Yeah.
You see what I mean by
this
flow, like,
yeah.
The flow just hits me. It's like,
and that was number four, right?
That was number four, yeah.
Ariana Grande, No Tears Left to Cry,
okay.
For me.
Okay.
Number four. I feel like for me, it's one of the best pop tracks of this year. Also because first of all, I really loved the video when she came in. I reacted to this song with the video, so you know what was my reaction, but it's just like, wow, like so unexpected, like the visuals were so amazing. Really felt like a great produced movie, like even like it was so great. And the song, the melody didn't disappoint. I really love her vocal like performance. Also, like, there were a lot of different elements throughout the song, to be honest. Like, for a pop song, it wasn't really basic, to be honest. Like, it was really interesting. And the other songs she came out with, The Light Is Coming with Nicki Minaj, I don't know if you liked it, but I liked it a lot. But this one, No Tears Left to Cry, I was listening to it a lot. Like, it's been more than 2 months it was released. Haven't stopped listening since then.
I mean, for me, for artists that I don't really listen to a lot, like religiously, I'll just wait till the album comes out.
Mm-hmm.
So I've heard the singles, but I didn't like listen to it constantly. So I don't really know. I don't really remember what it sounds like. But I remember the first time I listened to this one,
mm-hmm.
and I was like, yeah, it's pretty good. So yeah.
And what I want to say is, you said you really liked Ariana Grande's project albums, right? Like, you were listening to the albums before.
Oh, like Dangerous Woman and stuff.
Yeah,
I really did like Dangerous Woman.
Yeah.
But it didn't make me like a super fan.
Mm-hmm.
I liked that album, but her previous stuff, wasn't that big of a fan.
Mm-hmm.
I liked her R&B-ish style, like before her first album.
Uh-huh.
And the second album kind of missed. So I'm kind of still careful with what I'm going into. I'm not instantly like, oh my god, Ariana.
Yeah. For me, like, the reason why I asked you about it, because for me, I haven't listened to like Ariana Grande project, the songs I've heard from her, like, they were just okay, like, not the best, not the worst, but this one, like, yeah, it kind of like removed the shield, kind of like, of liking Ariana Grande. Yeah.
Give it a play.
I just realized I would have played the chorus because it's pretty great. Yeah. But anyway,
you get this stuff.
Yeah, it's pretty great.
Mine number three is Kyle Dion Brown. So Kyle Dion, I only recently like learned who he was. I think it was May or April. Mm-hmm. There was a concert at my school, at my university, where it was like a soul concert. Her was there, Marky Basie was there, and then there was this guy called Caldeon, never heard of him before.
Yeah.
And then he performed, and he was amazing. Like, he's got this falsetto, and just so much soul, and just, I got into him instantly after. I was like, shit, I gotta go listen to this guy. So I listened to him, and then he had an album in 2016, which was okay, but his singles, his three singles that are from his new album, which no one knows when it's coming out, he hasn't said anything about it. Mm-hmm. Are amazing, like Cool Side of the Pillow, what is it called? Brown, yeah, is the one I'm talking about. There's another one, I forgot what it's called for some reason. I can't, it's not in my brain right now.
Hold to me, something like that.
But it's a really good song. And this song is the 2018 single, mm-hmm. It's just whoa, like it just sounds like chocolate. It sounds like the voice is like smooth, like chocolate.
Wait, you said it, but I kind of like can hear like the, what is the name of the song?
Brown.
Okay.
So it's like, you know, yeah, so I played Brown. It for you before. But it's just, yeah, like damn, I'm excited for this album because of these three singles. Mm-hmm. They're crazy, out of this world, insane. So let's see. Just very funk.
Yeah, I always like, every time I listen to this song, I'm like, damn, let's not listen to this. I remember the chorus goes, oh,
yeah, like, you wanna hear it?
I mean,
yeah. I love it.
Yeah.
A lot. And I can't wait till this album goes.
Yeah, I also can't wait for Jump Out.
Yeah, well, yeah, but he doesn't have any songs this year, so I can't have him in my top 10.
Yeah, hopefully by the end of the year. My number 3 was Childish Gambino, This Is America.
Okay.
Yeah,
I considered putting that on, but I thought it was too mainstream.
Yeah, well, I'm like playing the mainstream guy.
He's the mainstream, I'm the
non-mainstream. Yeah. This America was obviously like when it came out, everybody was just like was shocked, like what is this, and like in a good way, like we were just so blown away by the fact that he could deliver such a powerful message in such a great way. The video when he he's dancing in front of you and then he distracts you from everything else that happens in the background, just like America does with the social media and the media, and also the fact that he was killing people in there, I mean for a reason, like just to show what America is about, like taking from the real events. The first one was the guy who he killed, Childish Gambino, like to the head shot, the father, he was the father, the guy who got killed in the video, he was the father of that son who was killed in the exact same way, like, so basically the father had
so the person who played the dead guy who died in the video was the father of someone who had been killed,
yeah,
like that in real life.
Yes, that's it. Thank you. Yeah, so also the second one was the second killing was of the whole choir in the church. It also happened in real life as well, not that long ago, so it's just a powerful message, and like I really love the melody as well, and when especially it goes to the soulful part where like the choir sings in, ooh, talking about it. Like, yeah, I really love it. I'm enjoying this track.
I really like that song too. When it came out, it was on repeat a lot. Mm-hmm. It came out at the same time as this Marky Bassey single. It's called Main Chick, which I was listening to them like both the two songs in a playlist, and I would just play one, two.
Is it on your list?
It's not on my list.
Oh shit. Some people are gonna be disappointed because
I love Marky Bassey, but I don't think that single is very strong. Mm-hmm. It's a good song, but it's probably one of his weakest singles. It's very shallow compared to what he usually drops. Yeah. It sounds nice, but like the lyrically, it just isn't that great. So I didn't put it on my list. But that and This Is America were going on for a while for me when they came out. Because This Is America is an amazing song, and also has the message, like you were saying. Mm-hmm. But, I didn't put either of them on my list because for different reasons.
Yeah, I have. I want to talk about Marky Bassey a little bit because I made a reaction to his last album, and people were really requesting me to react to Main Chick. I haven't done it, but I actually heard it before, so please stop requesting. I've heard it. I didn't stick with me though.
Yeah, he's probably one of my favorite artists right now. I mean, if you watch the Drake review, I was wearing a shirt Marky Bassey.
Yeah.
But that song is. I feel like it's just there to kind of be more mainstream because he's becoming more mainstream. Mm. But because usually the things that his music is a lot more complicated than that song. Mm. It's a good song, but it's not to his standard of to me, in my opinion.
Okay. And your
my number two.
Number two.
Really. My number two is Panic the Disco, Dying in L.A.
Uh-huh.
It's probably the only song off of his new album, or I guess he's there, but it's his new album, which is which isn't like really heavy production, like loud production. It's only piano. It's a piano ballad. It's talking about how, like, going to LA trying to be a star, and how they bring you in. They're like, oh my God, you're gonna be a star. Like, there's so many things around you. You're so overwhelmed. And then the next verse after the chorus is. Okay, you got trapped, you can't escape, and now they're telling you you're gonna fail.
Mm-hmm.
Because now, like, your stardom is over.
Mm-hmm.
So, like, you went in, like, oh, I can't believe this. Like, they're building up, everyone's telling you you're gonna be good, you're gonna be good. And then you didn't, and everyone's like, get out, like, you suck. Like, you can't do anything, you should just give up. Yeah. It's just like the whole album kind of talks about the darkness of Hollywood and LA, and that song especially. And his voice works perfectly with the piano. And it's just like, on Death of a Bachelor, he had a piano ballad, which I found it was cool, but it was kind of boring. Like, I don't listen to it. But this one, it's my favorite song of the album. And now my number two of the first
I would like to listen to it, but we didn't play This Is America as well.
Play This Is America. Yeah. Everyone's heard it, but we played it anyway.
We should probably stop at 38 seconds. But yeah, then it's a drop and like it goes crazy.
Yeah. Well, we forgot that. That's his number three.
Yeah, number two.
My number two, Dying in LA, Panic at the Disco. I kind of played it late earlier by accident. I don't know if we're gonna cut that off. Build you up, sun was in your eyes. You couldn't believe it. Riches all around, your walking stars are on the ground. Hollywood stars. Mm. You start to believe it. Every face along the boulevard is a dreamer. Just like you. You looked at death in a tarot card and you saw what you had to do. But nobody knows you now when you're dying in LA. And that's pretty much the gist of it. Just the lyrics of course changed.
Yeah, I'm hooked.
It's a very powerful song.
Yeah.
I really like it. That's my number two.
Awesome.
Go ahead.
My number two. Oh, I know about this. It's Pray For Me, The Weeknd, and Kendrick Lamar.
Okay.
Of the Black Panther soundtrack. I mean, it's Weeknd and Kendrick Lamar, one of our favorite artists, to be honest. That's why it's in there. Like, simply put it like that. But, like, I just love the song as well. Just perfect. 10 out of song. 10 out of 10 song 10 for
song.
Me.
10
out of
song.
Yeah, 10 out of 10 for me. I have nothing else to add to that.
I like that song a lot, but I feel like it's very radio made.
Yeah.
So I got tired of it.
I don't
it's
have
a problem
with
yeah, you like. I feel like yeah, your list is for the radio.
Yeah.
Very much. My list is not. I doubt any of these songs will be on the radio.
Yeah.
But yeah, it works. I like that song a lot, but.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Oh man. Yeah. We can always get so good.
yeah.
But yeah, and that's. All until this is number one. The next song is number one.
Yours number one.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
And your number one's next. And this is the number one song from January to June of this year for me personally. And you already heard which one it was.
Oh.
But,
oh, is it? Okay.
Yeah. And I don't know if we're going to cut whatever we're going to edit this. But if you haven't heard it and you haven't seen the previous video, my favorite song of this half of the year so far.
And the favorite album.
Is also my favorite album. Is from my favorite album, which is Shawn Mendes.
Yeah.
Mutual. Like, whoa! Like, when I heard this song, I was like, damn, but that's Shawn Mendes? What kind of style is this? I've never heard him anywhere near this kind of style.
Uh-huh.
And it's just like the it's kind of like a Jamaican beat, like
yeah.
Poof. And I said the chorus reminds me of that Nico and Vin song, Am I Wrong?
Yes.
Because the beat is very like kind of like that. The style of that beat is very similar to the chorus on here.
Mm-hmm.
But then his vocals are different. Like it's a different combination. It just adds to the versatility of that album. And I really like the way that this song is built. And how it sounds. And it's my number one. And I'm just gonna play it because I love it.
Yeah. I want you close, I want you closer. But when you're here with me, it's hard to tell just what you're after.
Here, beat ready?
Yeah.
You say,
oh, I didn't drop it.
All of me today, but tomorrow's not the same. My feelings never change. What do you want from me? What do you want?
Yeah.
I need to know if this is mutual before I go. And get me to evolve.
Yeah.
I want you back. Yeah, yeah, I love that song.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, favorite off the album, favorite of the year.
Damn. Crazy. Number one
number
album
one.
And number one
and
song
yeah.
by Shawn Mendes.
Yeah.
Damn. That's pretty crazy. Mine is different. Not Kanye West, actually.
Ooh, okay.
Yeah.
Wait, did you have any Kanye West?
No.
Damn!
That's why I was like, I'm not really satisfied with the top 10, but like, yeah, list been made. As I told you, like, before April, after April,
yeah.
nothing
yeah.
entered to this list. Kanye Harris, Dua Lipa, One Kiss.
Ah, okay.
Yeah, for me, because, how do I say it? Like, Kanye Harris, last year, if you have been following me, like I also put Calvin Harris songs like on top of my list because like I just really love Calvin Harris, like my one of my favorite DJs along with David Guetta. And this song, when I reacted to this song with Dua Lipa, first of all I was really excited that she's on his production, because Dua Lipa, she's been gaining momentum for me with the I Didn't Give a Fuck song and also the New Rules.
Mm-hmm.
Also there's a song Be The One, which is also an incredible song. And this song, when it finally delivered, I liked it, but I was like, it's pretty simple. Like it's repeating itself kind of, but it was still interesting for me enough. And then it just, from that point, I give it 7 out of 10 in my reaction, but then it just grew on me more and more and more. And like, it's been what, like 3 months almost since the release of this song, and I still listen to it every day. I just really love it.
Yeah, I don't think I've ever heard it.
Well, you heard it with me when we were going to
college. Oh, okay,
college.
Yeah, I do know. Okay.
Yeah, yeah.
But I've heard it like one time.
Yeah, I can play it.
Oh, I have heard this now.
Yeah. I just love the beats, like relaxing and and dancey at the same time.
Yeah. It's a really good song. I actually really like that song too.
Yeah, good.
Okay, let's top 10 of each.
Oh wait, you already said.
I went first.
I was like, because of the last year, yeah, like I was waiting. When's yours first? All right.
Yeah,
cool.
I'm
then.
Pretty satisfied with that, honestly.
Yeah.
Like, I feel like we both had, other than Migos.
Yeah.
We both had some pretty good lists. Yeah, if you want to, should we make like a playlist or something and post it?
Yeah, for sure. On Spotify.
Yeah. Top 10 or top 20, I guess.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
From Sam and Bob.
Yeah, and I'll also make a playlist on Apple Music, and you can follow me on Apple Music, see what I listen to, and also follow this playlist as well.
Yeah.
We're just gonna keep it like that. Thank you very much for watching this video. Thank you for sticking with us to the end of this video. Really appreciate it. Really love you. Love you, love you, love you. Mwah.
Yeah. Hopefully, we'll be back for the end of 2018.
Yeah.
And hopefully, John Bellion will be on there.
Yes, yes, yes. In case you don't know him, really check him out.
Yeah, probably literally my favorite artist.
Yeah, one of my favorite artists as well.
Maybe new Marky Bassey, maybe Kyle Dion, maybe some new like variety albums you can put in there.
Yeah. Hit the like button and subscribe to this channel. I'll see you guys in the next ones. Goodbye.
We have a TV show every Sunday, and we are a play. If he scores a hat trick, he can choose a song. So feel free, which one you like to hear?
Oh, Jesus, put me on this. I'll go One Kiss, Calvin Harris, and Dua Lipa. One kiss is all it takes, falling in love.